Betty, let's begin. The restaurant day unfortunately won't take place this year.
No, unfortunately, I'm very sad about it because we've had great success with it. But we just recently sent a letter to all the restaurants that have participated over the year to let them know that we aren't going to do it this year because we're concerned about them and their survival, and we want them to succeed and continue to be here. And thank them for their past generous contributions and I wish for their success, and perhaps it will be reinstated in the future.
Now, for people
So.
who aren't familiar, those restaurants would donate a portion of the
Yes.
money they receive back to support Lenore's Pantry.
Absolutely. It was an effort to get people to go out and enjoy the local restaurants. In the greater North Attleboro area, went into Attleboro and even into Plainville. And go enjoy your favorite restaurant for an evening, and that restaurant is going to donate a portion of the profit back to the food pantry. And we have been able to give Anne Marie, I think last year, somewhere around $6,000 or $7,000 to go toward the food pantry. So, for you to enjoy a lovely meal in your favorite restaurant, and for them to donate part of that back for someone who can't even put food on their table, never mind go to a restaurant.
And this year, of course, the restaurants so desperately need the money themselves. There was some good news coming out of the State House yesterday. Governor Charlie Baker
Yes.
expanding what restaurants can do. You'll be able to, I always love eating at the bar. Reminds me of the grill room at Highland Country Club.
Yes.
And for families like yours, you don't have to split up into two tables.
No, as I was telling you earlier, we like to take my son and his wife and their children out on Sunday night, and there's eight of us, and we can't sit at the same table. So I look forward to that because the conversation with the younger generation and the older generation sometimes is very interesting and educational. And when you're separated at two different tables, you can't do that. And I know we're not the only ones that have that issue. The other thing is, eating at the bar, I know is a treat for a lot of people, and I'm glad they'll be able to do that again. But I still am concerned for the restaurants because if you don't have a very long bar, 6 feet between people is still a challenge. So I encourage anyone who's listening who is able to go to our restaurants to please go out and patronize them. They're very safe. My husband and I are in one or another almost every night of the week, and they take great precautions, and we want them all to succeed.
On another note, I received a press release from your office today. I think 99.6% of the roll call votes you participated in. That's incredible.
Yes, I don't know how I missed one, but I did. I must have been in the bathroom or something. But that's our job. Our job, part of our job, is to be there and to vote on behalf of the people that you represent, to get up and argue issues. And you don't always win, but you have to express the feelings of the people you represent, and you have to be there to vote. That's your job.
And you've done it very well all these years,
Thank
but
you.
you still have a few months
I
left.
sure do. Tough months, but I do. And we are having a wonderful event this weekend here in North Attleboro. It's our annual food drive, and we will have a front-end loader parked at the entrance to Town Hall, and we partner with youth football, and of course they're not playing this year, but the families are still going to partner with me and participate. And the challenge is, how many times can we fill that front-end loader? Which Don Cerrone very graciously loans us.